Hi everyone, I'm Erin Lai with Remax All Points, and thank you for tuning in to my June market update. I'll be running through the current price trends and market conditions in the Tri-Cities. I hope you find it useful and interesting, and if you do, please like and subscribe to my channel or feel free to follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Let's jump straight into it. In Coquitlam, we're seeing softer sales ratios. Townhomes and condos still in seller's markets, detached hovering just above balanced market conditions with 24.9% sales ratio. Detached prices are up 23.1% from this time last year. Townhome prices are up 25.5% from this time last year. And condo prices are up 19% from this time last year. Similar trend in Port Coquitlam with softer sales ratios in all three product types. Townhomes and condos still in seller's market conditions, but detached hovering just above balanced market conditions with a 22% sales ratio. Detached prices are up 25.8% from this time last year. Townhome prices are up 26.7% from this time last year. And condo prices are up 20.3% from this time last year. Finally, in Port Moody, softer sales ratios in all three product types and detached have actually dipped into balanced market conditions with a 15.4% sales ratio. Detached prices are up 23.5% from this time last year. Townhome prices are up 28.3% from this time last year. And condo prices are up 17.5% from this time last year. The market is changing and shifting towards more favourable, balanced conditions. And this is in large part due to the rising interest rates, but also shifts in demand. For example, a lot of the people who were feeling the space pinch and needing more space while they were working from home may now have a back to the office solution, and that demand is no longer as pressing. We're also coming into summer, which is typically a slower period for real estate, which is making conditions a little bit more favourable for buyers. So we're seeing a little less competition, fewer offers if there are multiple offers, getting subjects back in offers, and just more time to make decisions, a less frenzied environment for buyers. I want to keep it short this month. The major thing or major issue to report on is updates in the cooling off period. So again, nothing's been enacted yet. No legislation has been released, but the BC Financial Services Authority, which is the governing body for real estate licensees, released their recommendations to the government. So this included a 5-day pre-offer period. So that's a period of time in which a seller may not accept an offer between when it was listed and when that 5 days is up. So the rationale behind this is to allow buyers time to view the unit and do some due diligence in that pre-offer period. The cooling off period, they've recommended 3 days, non-waivable, which I think is an important distinction. Also, a termination fee of between 0.1% to 0.5% of the purchase price for buyers who back out of a contract in the cooling off period to deter buyers from writing and holding up multiple properties at the same time. They're also encouraging the government to continue to explore the blind bidding process and encouraging them to explore open bidding or auction style or some sort of disclosure process so that buyers know how many offers they might be competing against and the price of other offers. So watch this space. Government said that they will be wanting to enact this over summer, so we'll see if that actually happens, but either way the market will be changing for both buyers and sellers in the near future, so watch this space. There you have it, nice and short. If you have any specific questions or particular questions that are useful to you, by all means, please reach out. I'm always ready and willing and able to help you with whatever it is that you're thinking of. And enjoy your summer. Enjoy the sun. Have a wonderful few months. And I will check in with you again for the next market update. If you found this useful and interesting, please like and subscribe to my channel or feel free to follow me on Facebook or Instagram. Until next time.